Good morning, students. In this lecture, we will see about the diode clippers. In our previous lectures, we have also seen the applications of a diode in different areas, as diode work as a rectifier, diode work as a light emitting diode, Zener diode, that is work as a voltage regulators, PN diode, so that is basically photodiode, so that is basically conversion of light signals into the form of electrical signals, LED, that is convert our electrical signals into the form of light. So these are the different applications of our diodes, which are also used in optical fiber communications. Now we will again take the something enhanced version of our rectifications. So already we have seen that how our rectifiers are work and how it will convert the shape of our signals. Means if you are talking about the rectifications, is the basic applications of diodes. So apart from that applications, clipper and clampers are also equally important. So first of all, we have seen that how it will rectify or change the shape of our waveforms. So clippers, so if you are talking about the clipper, so that is known as a limiters. Okay, so clipper is known as a limiters and clampers, that is known as a DC restorer. So basically, if in this lecture, we will study about the types of clippers and we will also see in the clampers how it will work. So first of all, we will start from our simple diode clippers. So in most of the electronic circuits, like we are amplifiers, modulators, many others have a particular range of voltage at which they have to accept the input signals. Okay, so there is a certain fixed ranges in which they are working. Any of signals that have an amplitude greater than this particular range may cause the distortions in the output of electronic circuit. So that circuit may be destroy and may even lead to damage. So they will be damaged. So there is a certain condition that these equipment will work only this given ranges. So that range can be decided by using the different types of circuit. So as in most of the electronic devices work on a single positive supply, input voltage range would also be a positive side. So that is basically a different criteria. Natural signals like audio signals, sinusoidal waveforms, many other contain both positive and negative cycles with varying amplitude in their durations. So these are the varieties of our signals which are existing at our different applications. So clipping of a waveform is the most common technique that apply to the input signals. So basically that technique is applied, we apply this technique to the input signal to adopt them, so that they may lie within the operating range of electronic circuitry. So that is basically the clipping circuits or devices are fix the basic operating range of our electronic circuit according to their design. Clipping of waveforms can be done by eliminating the portion of waveform which crosses the input range of circuit. So that particular range, if are crosses by that particular circuitry, so that particular part will be clipped by this clipper. So that is used. So according to applications, we have designed our different types of clipper. So here we will see the broad study about the clipper. So first of all, there is a series clipper. Second one is the shunt or parallel clippers. So series clipper circuit contains a power diode in series with the load connected at the end of the circuit. So in this type of circuit, our diode is connected in series with load, and shunt clipper, that is diode is connected in parallel with the load. So as we have to see, half wave rectifier circuit is similar to series clipper because it is also connected in series with the load. So if diode in series clipper circuit is forward bias condition, then output waveform at the load follows the input waveform. So that is the same as we have to see in our half wave rectification. If diode is forward bias, it will work as a short circuit and complete input signal will be transferred to the output waveforms. So when diode in reverse bias, so it is unable to conduct the current, it will work just like a open circuit and output of the current will be zero volt. So we have to already seen this type of, so you can see here, there is a series clipper and this is a shunt clipper. In shunt clipper, diode is connected in parallel with our load. So this is our two types of So the direction in which diode is connected determines the polarity of the clipped output waveform. So in which direction diode is connected, according to that we have to decide which type of portions will be clipped out. So if you are talking about the series clipper circuit, so if the diode is reverse biased, so what will happen? Series clipper circuit and diode is reverse biased means cathode is connected to the positive terminal and anode is connected to the load. So this circuit will be positive series clipping. And if we are called it a positive series clipper, means positive half cycles of input will be clipped off. Okay, so that is the reason. Second one is if diode is forward bias, means anode is connected to the positive side and cathode connected to the load, then circuit will be the negative series clipper. And in this condition, it will clip off the negative half part of our signals. So that is basically how we can connect our diode in the devices. So this is a basically all things is generally based on the how diode is connected and when it is the forward bias and how it will be the reverse bias. So according to that, we have decided our series positive clipper and series negative clipper. The series clipper diode has an output voltage V out that is equal to V input when diode is conducting. And when it is not conducting, so output voltage will be zero. So it is depend how it will be, what is the direction of our diode. So that is basically series in series connection. If we are talking about the series connection of clipper circuit, so in that particular circuit, what will happen here? If diode is working, then your output voltage is equal to input voltage. And if diode is not working, that conditions your output voltage is equal to 0 volt. Now in contrast to the series clipper circuit, if you are talking about a parallel clipper circuit that provides the output when diode is connected in reverse bias, so that is the reverse operation of the series clipper circuit. So when your diode is reverse biased and when it is not conducting, okay, so in that particular condition we will receive the output from our circuit. So we have to, according to different combinations, we will further see the different types of our series clipper circuit. So when diode is not conducting, the shunt combination diode act as a open circuit, okay, and both the series resistor and load resistor act as a voltage divider. So it will work as a voltage divider circuit and output voltage will be calculated. So we can see here ki how your input voltage will be calculated. So that is the basically the output voltage that is equal to input voltage across the R load resistance upon the total resistance R load per plus R series. So when diode is conducting, it acts as a short circuit, and when output voltage across the diode will be V out that is equal to 0 volt in parallel shunt clipper. Okay, so the series limiting resistor is connected in series with the supply to prevent the diode from short circuit. So in this case, output voltage of the circuit should be, so in this particular condition, output voltage of the circuit should be 0.7 volts, and it depends on the polarity of shunt clipper, which is determined by the direction of diode connections. So that is the basically shunt clipper. You can see here is a diode D1 and here is a supply. So above circuit is a shunt clipper circuit which uses a DC supply voltage. So by using this DC supply voltage, we can bias the diode, and it is the biasing voltage at which diode starts conducting. So by this biasing voltage, diode starts conducting, and diode in shunt with the clipper circuit. Okay, so in the shunt in the clipper circuit, it starts to conduct when it reaches the biasing voltage. So that is the basically the working of our shunt clipper. So clipper circuits are used in variety of systems, so to perform one of the two functions. So if you are talking about the clipper circuit, how it will work and what is the basic uses, so that is altering the waveform shape. So it will alter the shape of waveforms. So either sometimes it will clipped off upper half, either it will clipped off the negative half cycles, either it will clipped off the part of our upper half cycles, either it will be clipped off to the part of our. So that is the basic task of our clipper circuit, is that it will alter the waveform shape. So that is same as half wave rectifier, that will also change an alternating voltage into the DC waveform. Second is the protecting the circuit from transients. So the second applications of clipper circuit is that it will protect our circuit from transient. So what about the transient? So transient is defined as the abrupt change in current or voltage. So if there is a sudden change in current or voltage with extremely short duration, so that abrupt change in current or voltage will be for a very short duration. So clipper circuits can be used to protect our sensitive circuit from these type of fluctuations. So if in your main supply there is a slightly sudden enhancement or sudden rise in our voltage or current for a very short duration, so it is called as a transient, and clipper circuit will prevent us from protecting our device from this type of transient. So this is a basic applications of clipper circuits, and now we will apply the different biasing conditions and positions of their DC bias voltage for making the different shape of our output waveform. So one by one we will take the types of our clipper circuits. So again we will move to the types of clipper circuit. So what about the types? So we have already seen the basic working features, what is the positive clipper, what about the negative clipper. So according to that we will again start from the series negative clipper. So it is a basic clipper circuit using a diode, okay, and is nothing but a half wave rectifier. Because if you are talking about the negative clipper, means negative half cycles will be clipped off. So as the name, you can see from the basic name of that particular clipper, it will clip off the, so this is the same as where half wave rectification, upper half will be converted into the unidirectional current and lower half will be clipped off. So that is a basic same thing. Okay, when it is working and when it is not working, so that there is a diode, and it is clear that diode is forward bias during the positive cycles. So what about this one? We can see that in positive half cycles diode will be conducting, and if diode is conducting, so now what will happen there? When diode is conducting, it will offer a very low resistance and it will act as a closed switch. So hence the output voltage is equal to the positive half of the input voltage. So you can see here, that is a positive half input voltage. During the negative half cycles, diode is reverse biased and act as a open circuit, and as a result, output voltage during the positive half cycles VIN minus VT. So that is equal to 0 volt during the negative half. So that will again the positive half cycles and negative half cycles. So where VD is the threshold voltage of the diode. So we can call it as a threshold voltage. If diode is idle, then if you are talking about the idle diode, so at that particular conditions, threshold voltage of diode will be equal to 0 volt. So this is our types of clipper circuit. Now we will see the series positive clipper. So what will happen? Series negative clipper and series positive clipper. So basic theme of using this type of clipper circuit is reverting the diode. We can obtain a positive clipper configuration. So now again, whole process is based on that particular previous process. Bus only thing is that when you are reversing the diode, you can obtain a positive. Okay, so here polarity will be changed of diode. So cathode is connected to positive of the supply and anode is connected to the load, which makes our diode a reverse bias for positive cycle. So if you are there is a positive cycle, so at that positive cycle our diode will be reverse biased and forward bias for the negative half cycle. So that is the reason how our diode will work by connecting this way. So if we are working on the forward biasing state, output voltage will be 0, and if we are working on the negative half cycles, output voltage that is equal to V in plus VD. So what about the V in input signal, and VD is the basically threshold value of our diode. So that is a given to us. We will see again the shunt positive clipper. Okay, so that is a basically positive clipper. So as the name indicates, what will happen here? You can see in this diagram positive clipper circuits. So yeah, we are talking about the clipping. So clipped off. So what type of portions will be clipped off? Posterior half cycles. Okay. So posterior clipper means posterior half of the wave will be clipped off. If we are talking about the negative clipper circuits, mean negative half of the waveform will be clipped off. So that is basically, you can see here shunt. So your diode is connected in parallel with the load, and there is a current limiting resistance. So that is the R, and that is the input supply voltage VIN. So now anode is connected to the power supply through a resistor, and cathode is at the ground terminal. If we are talking about the positive half cycles, output voltage that is equal to VD volts, and during the negative half cycles, output voltage that is equal to VIN volts. So that is basically how much amount of output values. So that is the same. Shunt negative clippers. Okay, so as the name suggests here, shunt positive clipper means positive half cycles will be clipped off and you are receiving the negative half cycles. You can see here. When we are working on the negative shunt clipper, means negative half of the cycle will be clipped off and we are working on the positive half cycle. So you can see here. So this is the waveforms. This is a positive half cycles with time, and negative half cycles will be clipped off. So negative clipper means negative half cycles will be clipped off, and positive clipper means positive half cycles will be clipped off. So that is a diode D, and this in this way. So it is connected with shunt with the load RL. So now what will happen in this type of diagram, cathode is connected to the power supply and that is connected through a resistor R, and anode is maintained at the ground terminal. So during positive half cycles, output voltage V0 that is equal to VIN volts, and during the negative half cycles, output voltage that is equal to VD volts. So that is the positive half cycles. You can see here. Only positive half cycles exist and negative half cycles will be clipped off. This type of clipper circuit. Now series positive clipper with the positive bias. So here is again, we have to provide a biasing, and your it is a positive clipper means positive half cycles will be clipped off. But here we have to also apply a positive DC supply. So what is the value of your DC supply? DC supply is equal to the up. VDC. So we will denote it as a VDC. So what is the role of this VDC? Positive half cycles. What will happen here? Cathode is connected to the positive terminal and anode is connected to the negative terminal. So when your VIN input is less than VD plus VDC, output voltage will follow the same. When your VID plus VDC greater than 1, okay, so this voltage is with respect to this voltage VIN, input voltage is greater than VD plus VDC. So output voltage is equal to VDC. So you can see, and if you are talking about the negative half cycles, cathode is connected to the negative half cycles and anode is connected to the positive half cycles. So we will see output voltage that is equal to VIN plus VD. This is the waveforms which we have to receive in positive clipper with positive bias. Now again, we have to very finely read the basic what is the name of your circuit, so that you can see series. So you have to focus on your diode is connected in series, positive clipper with positive bias voltage connected in series. So that is basically positive bias voltage is connected, and these voltage, what type of positive biasing voltage you are using, that is connected in series with the diode. So this is our basic system. What about the positive half cycles and negative half cycles? We are talking about the positive half cycles, means anode is maintained at the ground potential and cathode is connected to the positive terminal. And in this type of biasing, what will happen there? Diode will reverse bias during the whole positive half cycle because diode is connected in the reverse mode. So now, if diode is reverse bias, then positive half cycles, your output voltage will be 0 volt. And now what will happen in negative half cycles, you can also see in this diagram. So how your diode is connected and positive half cycles and negative half cycles, what is the rule? You can see from here. So for positive half cycles, what will happen there? Anode is maintained at the ground potential. I have already told you. What about the negative half cycles? So in negative half cycles, anode is maintained at ground potential and cathode is again connected to the negative supply. In upper half, that is connected to the positive supply. So when VIN is less than VD plus VDC, so now what will happen? Input voltage is less than VD plus VDC, so output voltage, that is also equal to 0 volt. And when VIN, that is greater than VD plus VDC, so output voltage, that is higher than the input voltage plus VDC voltage. Also, you will see our circuit diagram. So how this voltage will be added during the input voltage. So that means you will be shift your input signal by VDC amount. So that is the basic. Now, what is about the series positive clipper with negative bias voltage? So what about the series positive clipper? Positive half cycles. So since your clipper is positive clipper, means positive half cycles will be clipped off with, you have to provide the negative bias voltage. So that is a very classification of this type of clipper circuit. So now what will happen here? Cathode is connected to the positive supply and anode is maintained at the negative bias potential. So now what will happen here? Output voltage V0, that is equal to minus VDC volt. Okay. So you can see in this place, your output voltage, that is equal to minus VDC volt in positive half cycles. And in the negative half cycles, your cathode is connected to the negative supply and anode is maintained at the negative bias potential. So when your VI input is less than VD plus VDC, so your output voltage is only DC in negative directions. And greater than this, VIN plus VD, you can follow that path. So you can see this diagram in your waveforms. Your waveform will be shifted in the negative half directions. Now, series positive clipper with negative bias voltage. So that is us. You can see the bias voltage and negative bias voltage. So the negative terminal is connected to this diode. And this is a positive clipper, mean positive half cycle. Be clipped off. So here again you can see that anode is maintained at the ground potentials and cathode observed as a variable voltage. So diode is forward biased during the whole positive half cycles. Diode will be forward biased. So when VIN is less than VDC minus VD, output voltage, that is equal to VIN minus VDC plus VD volts. And when VIN is greater than the VD plus VDC, output voltage will be equal to 0 volt. So now what will happen here? The basic condition is follow that. When your, that is the VIN is greater than the VDC plus VDC, your output voltage will be 0 volt. So now you can see and negative half cycles, again anode is maintained at the ground potential and cathode observe the variable negative voltage. So diode will be forward biased during the negative half cycle. So all thing is based on how you have to connected your DC supply, how your diode is connected, in which directions your diode is connected, and according to that you will achieve your output voltage. So your output voltage VIN minus VDC plus VD. So that is the negative half cycles. So you can also see here, this is only a simple connection. Now you can see the series negative clipper. That is a negative clipper means negative half cycles will be clipped off, but you have to given the positive bias voltage. So now what will happen here? This is a positive voltage. You are providing the series negative clipper. So diode is connected in series. Okay. it positive bias voltage, you have to apply. Now what will happen? In the, you can see here, after some time it will off, then it will be start to on, and in the second half second your output voltage is equal to DC. So this is the final waveforms of our signal. So you can see here, in positive half cycles, in this case anode is connected positive supply and cathode is again maintained at the positive bias, because we have to provide a bias potential. So when VID is less than VD plus VDC, so at that particular condition output voltage is equal to constant VDC. But when it will increases, so that in that particular value output voltage follows the input, so that is the current input. And negative half cycle, in this case anode is connected to the negative supply, so at that particular condition output voltage, that is equal to VDC. So negative half cycle, so you can see here, in negative half cycles you will maintain it at the DC level, and after then it will follow your sinusoidal VIN equal to output voltage. So this is the final shape of our waveforms. So I think it will be clear to you. Now we will see the series negative clipper with positive bias voltage connected in series. Okay, so that is a series negative clipper, means again it will be negative half cycles will cut off, but here the polarity of biasing is changed. Okay, so what now, what in positive half cycles, again we are seeing that it is maintained at a negative potential, and anode is the variable voltage. So what will happen, diode is forward bias. So how, when diode is forward bias, when VIN is less than VD plus VDC, so that is follow the input VIN, and when VIN is greater than VD plus VDC, so output voltage is equal to 0 volt. So now what will happen in the negative half cycles, cathode is maintained at the negative potentials and anode observe the variable negative voltage. So when VIN, that is output voltage V0, that is equal to VIN plus VDC minus VD volts. And when that is equal to greater than this one, VIN is greater than this, then output voltage is 0. So in this way, we will receive this type of waveforms, our output according to that in the negative half cycles. Now you will see the series negative clipper. So that is the basic shape of our negative clipper with the negative bias voltage connected in parallel. So that is the biasing of your voltage. Instead of here, it will connect it in this place. Into that, in positive half cycles, and there is a negative clipper, so you are completely not clipped off, completely negative, but because there is also a bias voltage is connected. So in negative half cycles you will get such type of waveforms, and a small part of that one will be clipped off. So same thing is here, what will happen here in positive half cycles, in this circuit anode is connected to the positive supply and cathode is maintained at the negative bias. So what about the VIN? When VIN is less than VD plus VDC, so output voltage is equal to same whatever the input side, and when VIN is greater than this one, so output voltage will be plus VDC level. So that is maintained at the VDC level shifting. In negative half cycles, in this circuit anode is connected to the negative supply and cathode is connected to the, so basically negative supply, in this way output voltage, that is equal to VIN plus VD volts. So you can also little bit switch to the series negative clipper, negative bias connected. We will see this part. I think it will be the, there is a change in polarity of our signal. So we will see here again what will happen here. You have a negative clipper, so not completely negative half cycles will be clipped off. So what will happen in positive half cycles, here again direction of diode is reverse. So here cathode is maintained at the VDC and anode observe a variable voltage. So VIN, that is less than VD plus VDC, so output voltage is equal to 0 volt. And when VIN is greater than VD plus VDC, output voltage is equal to VIN minus VDC minus VD volts. So that is the positive half cycles, and in negative half cycles, cathode is maintained at the VDC and anode observe a variable negative voltage. So diode will be reverse biased during the negative half cycle. So that is a completely 0 volt at the output voltage. So you can receive this type of waveforms. That is a time limited. So that is basically for shunt posterior. We will see this type of waveforms in this. Generally, you have to apply what type of waveform. Now we will move to the shunt positive clipper. So that is basically, if you are talking about the shunt, means diode is connected in parallel with the load, and there is again a positive shunt bias voltage. So there is a VDC voltage and anode is connected to the positive supply. So it is a positive clipper, means positive half cycles will be totally clipped off, but since you have a positive shunt bias voltage, so completely not clipped off. After certain maintaining a voltage of VDC, then it will be clipped off. So positive half cycle in this circuit, anode is connected to the positive supply and cathode is maintained at the positive bias terminal. So if it is less than, it will follow the VIN, and after, when VIN is greater than VD plus VDC, it will be maintained the DC supply at the particular. What about the negative half cycles? In this negative half cycles, anode is connected to the negative supply, cathode is connected to the positive supply. So that is, output will follow the same as the VIN volts. So that is the basically. Now we will shunt positive clipper with the negative shunt bias voltage. So you can see here, polarity of this one we have to change. And according to that, there is a positive clipper, means positive half cycle will be clipped off, and we can achieve the current at the particular negative shunt bias in this path of this circuit. So again, there is a positive half cycles, anode is connected to the positive supply, and cathode is maintained negative, output voltage is zero, or that is equal to minus VDC. So that is moved to the minus VDC in positive half cycles and negative half cycles in this circuit. Anode is connected to the positive supply and cathode is maintained at the negative supply. Okay. So now what will happen? VIN is less than VDC. Output voltage is minus VDC plus VD. And if VIN is greater than VDC, then output voltage, that is follow the VIN volts. So that is the basically different voltage, however system is working. So you have to very slightly remember. Now we will see the shunt negative clipper with the forward biasing. So that is a diode connected. So here is the output waveforms. Only a part of it we can receive as a output waveform. So and this is the biasing conditions. So in positive half cycles, again cathode is connected to the positive terminal and anode is maintained at the negative. So now what will happen here? VIN is less than VDC minus VD. So V0, that is equal to VDC minus. So what will happen when this is less than this? So your output voltage will be equal to this, and this is greater than this, then your output voltage is follow the input voltage. And if you are talking about the negative half cycle, so cathode is connected to the negative supply and anode is maintained at the positive bias terminal. So that is VDC minus VD volts, output voltage. Now clipping both half wave cycles. So here we will again see, what about the clipping circuits? We will see here two diodes are connected in parallel, D1 and D2, and we have to also given the supply voltage of VDC1 and VDC2. So according to that supply voltage, our both the diodes will be working. So if you are talking about the positive half cycles, so in this cycle, cathode of the first diode is maintained at the plus VDC1, and its anode observe a variable positive voltage. Similarly, anode of diode D2 is maintained at the minus VDC2, and its cathode observe a variable positive. So according to D2, will be completely reverse biased during the whole positive half cycles. So that is the basically, if input is less than this one, D1, D2 are reverse biased. Output voltage VIN loads. When VIN is greater than this range, diode D1 will be forward biased and D2 will be reverse biased, and output voltage V0, that is equal to VDC1 plus VD1 volts. Same thing is if we are talking about the negative half cycle. In this cycle, cathode of diode D1 is maintained at the plus VDC1, and its anode observe a variable negative supply. So similarly, anode of diode D2 is maintained at the minus VDC2 and its cathode observes a variable negative. So according to that, VIN less than VDC2 plus VD2, so diode D1 and D2 are reverse bias and output voltage is equal to VIN. And when VIN is greater than of these two ranges, diode D2 will be forward bias and D1 will be the reverse bias. And output voltage V0, that is equal to VDC2 minus VD2. So that is, so in this case, two sides clipping circuit, both the positive and negative clipping levels can be varied independently. And this type of circuit is called as a parallel based clipper. So this circuit is basically a parallel based clipper. These are the different types of our clipping circuits which are used according to our use key, what amount of that input waveforms we are required to clip off and in which particular part we want to work out. So according to our requirement, we can design by using the different combinations of our DC supply and our diode, direction of our diode, we can design a different shape of our clipper circuits. Now we will see the types of our clamper circuit. So if we are talking about the clamper circuit, so the circuit of a positive clamper is shown, basically that consists of a three main elements. So that is the capacitor, diode and load resistor. So that is basically clamper. So if diode is connected in parallel to the load in such a way that cathode of diode is connected to the capacitor and anode to the ground. So let's analyze the circuit starting with negative half cycles. During the first negative cycle, diode is forward bias and act as a switch. And as a result, capacitor charges to the peak voltage, okay, VC. So you can see here. Output voltage is V0 and we are getting the two types of output voltage, means our whole voltage is shifted to the upward by Vset. So output voltage V0, that is equal to VIN plus VC. So VC is the peak of input voltage and from the above equation it is clear that above circuit adds a positive DC shift to the input. So there is only if input voltage is shifted by a VC, and what about the VC? VC is the peak of our input voltage, that it will be the charged. Now we will again positive clamper with the positive reference voltage. So here positive reference voltage, so we can see in this diagram, there is a diode and it is a, there is a reference voltage, positive reference voltage connected with a diode, and this is a capacitor which will be charged to the peak. You can see here in positive reference voltage is connected in series with the diode in positive clamper circuit such that positive terminal of reference is connected in series with the anode of the diode. So operation is similar as we have to see in our above circuit, that capacitor charges again to the peak of your input voltage. And according to that, VP is the peak voltage and VDC is the DC reference. So if you are talking about the capacitor voltage VC, then the capacitor voltage VC, that is equal to VP, peak voltage plus the DC voltage. So output is equal to VIN plus VC. So that is the basic thing, and we will shift here by using the VIN plus positive clamper with the negative references. So during the negative half cycles, diode starts conducting and capacitor charges to VP minus VDC. So during the consecutive positive and negative half cycles of the input waveform, diode pretty much doesn't conduct. Okay. And as a result, output is equal to the sum of the voltage stored in the capacitor and applied the input. So that is VC, that is equal to VP minus VDC. So output voltage is VIN plus VC. So total output voltage is equal to the input voltage plus whatever the voltage across the VC, and that is equal to VP minus. So the shift is still positive but less than the peak by VDC. So instead of shifting by VDC, that will be the less than VDC. So that is a basic output waveforms. What about the negative clamper? So negative clamper circuit consists of a diode connected in parallel with the load. So that is a negative clamper. The capacitor used in clamping circuit can be used such that it must charge very quickly and it should not discharge very drastically. Okay, so we have to choose such type of capacitor. Anode of diode is connected to the capacitor and cathode to the ground. So during the first positive half cycles of input, diode is in forward bias, and as the diode conducts, capacitor charges very quickly to the peak of the input Vp. So that is the basic voltage. So you can see here your complete is shifted to the negative directions according to your this. Now during the subsequent negative and positive half cycles of the input, the diode will be in the reverse bias and diode will not conduct. So output voltage will be equal to the sum of the applied input voltage and plus charge stored in the capacitor. So output waveform is the same as the input waveform. Now negative clamper with the positive reference. So the circuit arrangement is very similar to the negative clamper circuit, but a DC reference supply is connected in series with the diode. And output waveform is also similar to the negative clamper output waveform, but it is shifted towards the positive direction by amount equal to the reference voltage. So this is also same thing is here, only supply is connected. So negative clamper with the negative reference voltage. So in the reference voltage directions, the above cases are reverse biased and connected to the diode in series. And during the positive half cycles, diode starts conducting current before applying input voltage. And since cathode has a very small negative reference voltage, less than 0 volts, so waveform is shifted away from 0 volts towards the negative direction by amount of reference voltage. So you can see here. So used for generating the basically applications of clippers. So this is used for generation of new waveforms, shaping the existing older waveforms. So it will be used for correction and new generation. Clippers can be used as a freewheeling diode in protecting the transistor from transient effects by connecting the diode in parallel with the inductive mode. So there may be a precautions. Generally, it will be used as a freewheeling diode in protecting our transistors. Commonly used in power supply, the separation of synchronization signals existing from the composite color picture signal. So here is also used a DC insertion. Okay, so we have also used in color TV. Frequently used in FM transmitter for removing the excessive ripples in the signal above a certain noise level. So we are again maintaining our this level by using a clippers, and we can be clipped off. If we are talking about the applications of our clampers. So clampers can be frequently used in removing the distortions and identification of polarity of the circuit. For improving the reverse recovery time, clampers are used. Clamping circuits can be used as a voltage doublers and for modeling the existing waveform to a required shape and range. Clampers are widely used in test equipment and other sonar systems. So that is basically applications of our clampers, where we are used for according to our applications. So we have designed such type of clampers that is beneficial for that particular applications. So now there is a certain questions based on this, which circuit we have to obtain for desired output waveform in operational amplifiers. We are also using clipper and clamper circuit. So what is the basic circuit we have to require? Clipping level in the op-amp is determined. How we can determine this level? What is the condition of our positive clipper? The diode conducts, so in which particular condition diode will conduct? What happens if the input voltage is higher than the reference voltage in the positive clipper circuit? So that is also input voltage is higher than the reference voltage in a positive clipper. So you have to decide what is the conditions. You have to bias slightly with a very fine way. You have to study about the what is the role of your DC bias circuit, what is the role of your diode, how you connect your diode in the reverse biased operations or in the forward bias operations, how they will work out. So all things you have to rectify your signals. Diode in the small signal positive half-wave rectifier circuit act as a idle diode, clipper, clamper diode. So you have to work out on this one. Which of the following is not a necessary component in the clamper circuit? So diode, capacitor, resistor, So that are the different circuits which we have to work out. Op-amp clamper circuit is also referred as a, so what type of clamper circuit we are opting here. There is also a questions, there is a diagram, so you have to just see how our diode is connected and what is the minimum value of our output waveforms. We have to given a DC supply of 5 volt input range, so we have to given the peak value of your circuit. So by applying this, you can solve this numerical or this type of multiples which we have to see. So I think it will be clear to you how our clampers are work and how our clipping circuits. So we can see if we are working on the clamper, whole complete your input signal will be shifted to a certain level. Okay, so either it will be certain to the V saturation level or it will certain to the different level. So this is basically a DC restorer. Our clamper is work as a DC restorer circuits, and it will shift our circuit to the positive or negative half directions. But if we are talking about the clipper circuits, so it will slightly clipped off or cut the small part of our sinusoidal waveforms or a small part of our output waveform. So that is work behind that clipping and DC insertion. So these both types of circuits are very useful for our different applications of electronic circuitry. So you can use these circuit in different applications, how much part of input signal you want to clip off. Okay, thank you.